So welcome guys once again to Med Corner. Today we are continuing our videos on the immunology which we have started. In previous video we have seen about the ABO blood grouping system, and in this video we are going to see about the RH blood grouping system. Okay, so we know this ABO and RH are related to antigen and antibodies. So before going through this, I will just give a short description that how this RH blood group system has been developed or how it has been derived. So let's see what happened in year like about 1940. what the researchers has done. First of all, this RH, this name, it comes from monkey, and it comes from rhesus monkey. Okay, so what researchers has done in 1940 is about they from monkey they transfer monkey RBCs are red blood cells to rabbit. So what the result came was, when they transferred the monkey RBCs into the rabbit started to form antibodies against these RBCs. Okay, rabbit started to develop antibodies against this RBC, and when this RBC, when these antibodies which rabbit developed against this RBC was again back reacted with RBCs of monkey, rhesus monkey, it shows 100% agglutination. That means it cross reacted with this RBCs of monkey. If again after some time, when the same with same antibodies, when they cross link with the human RBC, they found that 85% of black human population in Americans, they show about agglutination. That means cross reaction or reacted against these antibodies, and 15% of the population, this was 85%, and the 15% population did not show any reaction. They did RBCs did not went agglutination. Agglutinated. So what the result point of this was, on the RBC of this monkey, there was some antigen which they called it as RH antigen, and when antibodies against this RH antigen was formed in the rat, and it again reacted with the rhesus monkey, it shows 100% agglutination, and in human it shows 85% agglutination. That means what, there is something common between the similarity between the RH monkey and the human. And later on they came to the point that those in human in which there is agglutination, they called it as RH positive, and those in which they did not show in response or agglutination, in which there was no cross reaction, they called as RH negative. So this was about the general miss from where this RH and antigen came. Now let's see some of about the how is the nature of the RH antigen. So actually the main difference which you will find in last video, we have seen ABO blood grouping system. The main difference between ABO and RH is this RH antigen are proteins, whereas in ABO the antigen A and B which we have seen, they are oligosaccharides or carbohydrates. So this is the main difference between both of them. Now, if we see, we know that the Rh antigen, Rh antigens are mostly proteins. If we see their structure little bit, we will find that, suppose, let's draw. This is an RBC, suppose, and I will draw Rh antigen. So, as we seen in ABO system, that the antigens were on the surface of the membrane, but in this antigens are integrating. They are passing through this membrane, and how many times they are passing? They are passing 12 times through this membrane. They are passing 12 times, and so this is also called as 12 pass membrane protein. Okay, this is also called as 12 pass membrane protein. Now we know if this is a protein, that means it has peptide chains consisting of amino acids. So there must be amino group and carboxyl group, and these both amino and carboxyl group are intracellular. And if we see, there are six total, 3, 4, 5, 6 extracellular loops and 6 intracellular loop, and the thing, the antigen which will be present on this peptide chain will be on extracellular domain, extracellular epitopes. It may be present here, it may be present here, it may be present here. This was. Now, actually Rh system is not a single, consist of not a single antigen, it's a group of systems. So now if we see there are almost 30 antigens in Rh system, but the mostly 5 are important in that. So if one, I will just erase it. Okay, so mostly 5 are very much important. Which are they? So first I will write it here. Antigen. The most important one and the most prevalent is D antigen. Remember, it's capital D. Another one is capital C or small C, and one more is capital E or small E. I did not mention small d. That means it is not present. So this we need to remember. So there are 5 total, which is very much important: D, capital D, capital C or small c, capital E or small e. Now where are they present on this? I told you they are present on the extracellular loop and extracellular domain. So this D antigen are present on this first extracellular loop. And I will mark like this because it's very much important. The second one is present on this second loop, that is C, capital C or small c. And the third one, which we talk about, capital E or small e, it's present on fourth loop. Or small e. So this was about regarding the structures of it, and one more thing. The gene which is responsible for making these antigens and this membrane proteins, there are two type of genes. That is, the first one is RhD gene, which will mostly make D antigen, and the second one is RhCe gene. We will talk about more about this gene in our further videos. But just for the point to be remembered that there are two type of genes, that is RhD genes and RhC genes. RhD genes will mostly make it a D antigen, whereas RhCe, these two genes means it actually it's combined. So this same gene will make the both the antigen. Okay, now some terminologies that which we need to understand is RH, this I told you this, that D, this is which will make D antigen is most important, and it is also most immunogenic. That means what? When it cross link or cross react with the D antibodies or D antigen, it will show much more reaction as compared to this C, capital C or small c, or capital E or small e. Okay, as it is most prevalent and it's most commonly found and it's most prevalent, that's why most of the time Rh positive people are also called as D positive, because it is most common. So now from now onwards, if we mention that Rh positive, you should get in your mind that Rh positive means D positive. So patient must be D positive. Okay, and if Rh negative, that means patient is D negative. Okay, now this is about just a little bit that we need to remember for our further videos. Now if we see, just let me, there are some terminologies that we need to understand regarding about this is, suppose let me draw one. So suppose I told you that Rh positive means the person is having D positive, okay, D antigen most of the time. So suppose here is a D antigen, D. So if the D antigen present, that means the person is D positive, okay, or Rh positive. Remember, these Rh antigen are also called as Rh factors. So it can be also called as person is positive for Rh factor. Now if it's not present here, that means it's Rh negative or B negative. Okay, but sometime what happens is these D antigens are present, but it present in less amount, means quantitative wise it's less present as compared to this one. So what we called it as weak D. We called it weak D. Okay, and sometimes again one more condition is like this: if Rh antigen, that is D, is present, but in quantity wise it's more, same like the first one. But the thing is that quality wise there must be some abnormalities in these genes, abnormality in this antigen which are producing it. So means qualitative wise it is less, so it sometimes it is called as partial Rh positive. Okay, so this was just regarding some terminology which will be helpful in your genetic combinations for this. Now if we see by this if we consider how many blood groups can be formed if we combine the ABO and the Rh group system. So let's see. I should draw one here also. So if the person has a blood group A, there must be bulk antigen A. Okay, but if the person is Rh positive, for suppose this is Candice, and the Rh positive, I told you it's protein. To suppose it's like this, it will be like this, and if it's protein, so consider it as like a chicken piece, and this is Candice. So if it's present, this, if A antigen is present, that means person blood group is A, and if D antigen present, I told you means D antigen present means Rh positive. So if D antigen is present here, so it will become A positive. Same with the B, if the person is having B antigen, if person is having B antigen and again that Rh positive or D positive is present, so it will become B positive. Same with AB, if Rh positive is present, then it will become AB positive. Same with O. O means there is no antigen A, there is no antigen B, but it's not without antigen. There is something present, that is H antigen. And remember, this this A and B antigen are modification of H antigen. So if H antigen present and Rh positive it's or D positive is present, it's also called O positive. And if we see that if there is no Rh antigen or D positive, if they are negative, then it will be, if A blood group A, B, AB, O, then it will be A negative, B negative, AB negative and O negative. So this was regarding our grouping systems of Rh. Now in next videos, I will continue with the comparison between, special comparison between ABO and Rh grouping system. So thank you. If you have any query, you can comment in the comment box. Thank you.